After dinner, I go back to my room. It's almost 10 o'clock. While I was eating, he placed the key on my desk. Now then, till I go, placing my knife in my pocket, I leave my room as quietly as I can. It's probably because of all the recent murders, but it's only 10 o'clock. There's no one in the park. The empty night hangs overhead. There, a white figure stands. Kiki, as soon as she sees me, Hagrid angrily yells at me. Hey, what time do you think it is? You're 20 minutes late. Since you came here right on time. Yeah, sorry, I left before 10 o'clock, but it took some time trying to leave the mansion without Akia noticing. Definitely be on time the next time, but please forgive me. Jeez, you don't seem to realize we are going to go killing. Hagrid practically bouts. Don't tell me. Just waiting long before the promised time. Hagrid, this whole time are you waiting for me? Me? I came here as soon as I woke up, so... Hagrid thinks it's over. Probably since 7 o'clock. Ah, oh, that's just adorable. 7? You were waiting for more than 3 hours? What in the world was she thinking? Coming here 3 hours early? She's probably just bored and lonely. It seems I'm strange. She's truly amazed. Hagrid mumbles to herself. Well, I'm partly to blame because I was late, but don't you have some issues too? If you're gone before the agreed time, then of course you'll have to wait. Hey, that's something entirely different. The fact you were late doesn't change. Well, that is true. But why did you wait 3 hours? You had that much time. Couldn't you have just come back to your room? I don't know why either. It was somehow fun while I was thinking it was nice waiting for you. It was already 10 o'clock. Fun? Why? Who knows? Didn't I say I didn't understand it myself? Maybe because you killed me that time. Something broke that couldn't be healed. I think it's strange myself, but I can't understand what's broken inside me. Having to say that is very troubling. Have you sliced her into 17 pieces? If she says there's something wrong, all I can do is to apologize. It's okay, we don't have much time. We can't waste time talking about more such things, Shiki. Yeah. I think that really helps me out. But if you're ever late again, I'll just have to go to your house and pick you up. Well, that's going to be troublesome. Better be on time. Next time, you're the one who couldn't keep the promise, so you have no complaints, right? No way, I'll keep it. But random unfortunate circumstances like today could happen at any time. Marmalade, that'll be the last thing you should do. Look. Don't come to my house, even if it's a mistake. What's more, Akia doesn't know about all this, But please don't make things more complicated than it is. Akia? Your sister doesn't look at all like you. You said a little too much, but yes. I see. You're that scared of your little sister? Shut up. I just don't want to worry her. At the very least, best, I'm a bother to her. I don't want to tire her out even further. You really are sweet to your sister, Shiki. I'm basically nice to everyone. Well, recently, there's been an exception to that.
And that's so cute. Yes.
That's just too adorable. Like she's proud of that. That's me. I always dance. An insult. Not a compliment. Not at all. Are you? I'm an exception, right? How could I not like that? She smiles again. Child smile, bright and carefree. If I keep seeing that, I will lose all my venom. I'm tired all of a sudden. Let's start looking for the vampire, agreed. Yes, it's about time. Then he'll start walking around town. Kiki, I want you to take off your glasses, but is that alright? Take off my glasses? Why? It's hard to notice them, but just me. I can sense the presence of humans and non-humans, but it won't help me find the vampire. All I can sense is the presence, but with your eyes, you can quickly tell between living and dead things. Like Shiki is a human-made weapon to hunt non-human things. It's a waste. We don't use what we have, right? Certainly, I can understand what she's saying. But taking off my glasses means, I know. Even I could feel your eyes getting stronger these past few days. And if you keep doing this, it might not be good for your health. I'm still saying despite that. But just lies up to you. I'm not going to force you. If you think it's alright to do so, take your glasses off and follow me. Take off my glasses and walk around town. I haven't done that since I received these glasses 8 years ago. First place, all the things I see without my glasses give me such a headache. It would be easy to imagine what would happen if I walked around town. Still, just like Aguito keeps going even though her wound hasn't healed, Tonashiki should do the same and pay back its debt. Aguidai, I'm fine. Isn't it just a headache? Compared to the pain her body must be feeling, this is nothing. It's fine. I can take off my glasses. It's a small price to pay. Make a search easier. I see. Then let's go, Shiki. Akui turns around and starts walking. Take off my glasses as I follow her. Follow Arkweed. I haven't walked in sceneries or riddles with lines since my hospitalization back then. And there's also the fact that somehow his vision is always purple. Or at least the last time he took off the glasses, and now essentially enough, I don't get a headache. It seems just seeing them won't cause it. It's not the thin lines in the buildings, but seeing the lines on the people walking by makes me sick. Or I thought they were just lines that were easy to cut along, but now I know they are the death of things, why I feel disgust first. It's not that those figures of people scribbles over with lines are disgusting, just seeing that humans are in existence so close to death makes me feel like throwing up. We walked the nighttime streets. Haki doesn't say anything, just continues to stride forth resolutely. We walk for hours in the midst of town. In the end, we don't see one aberration, not one person wrapped in death. Tiki, you can put your glasses back on. Seems like no matter how much you search tonight, it'll be useless. Aquit concludes with a sigh. I put my glasses back on. My vision returns back to normal, and I relax. Useless? Is it okay to just decide that all of a sudden? We've only looked everywhere once, right? No, just once is enough. The presence of the dead tend to linger around the place. Sorry, my mind just derped for a moment. I was just thinking. It was quite obvious that she could sense the dead, so that's quite a team in theory, that Hagrid would be the one to go to a general place and Tiki being the one to pinpoint the exact person out. That would work really well. But I haven't sensed any of them around at all, so there aren't any that are active. The enemy is alert now that most of his dead are defeated. Seriously, he really is a coward. I was so prepared to finish it all tonight, but it appears he still wants to play hide and seek. Hagrid bites a lip dissatisfied. You look like you're in a bad mood, Hagrid. Of course I am. You went through such trouble to help me, but it's so meaningless now. Well, I don't really mind. If you're that dissatisfied, I don't mind going out to look again. Maybe if I concentrate more, we can find something. That's not good. I can't train you anymore. Train? You're not really straining. You are. You might not realize it, but if you abuse your brain anymore, you might end up disabled. Damn, that can be really, really, really bad. Disabled? Oh, you. That's right. Don't exactly know how your eyes work. Okay. You said yourself that it was easier to see the death of living things than non-living things, right? Basically, it's a problem of the secretory of your brain. Death of things. Being able to see the cause and effect closer to reading than seeing. Everything has a main reason. The one source. It's the same thing that a German scientist calls the Akashic Record. In other words, it's the core of all phenomena. There's something that records all things. It's less of a record than an existence, so it isn't information. It just exists. It doesn't have any purpose in and of itself, or any direction. It's like a root swirl from which flows out all reasons. Things in this world flow from that, derive from that, and preserve their current form. You and I, vampires and humans, we all originated from that. Things became more complex and separate. Cannot return to that original source. In the beginning, but you understand that there exists the one, right? But no matter how different a form something takes from the great source, it is still a derivative. So even if it's only a slender line, there's a thread connecting to the source. The source of all things, the record that records the beginning and the end of all things. Being connected to that means knowing the end of all things. Originally, the brain has the ability to control reception and transmission. None of humans close off all of these circuits, except for themselves. But there are those people who have their circuits open latently, without a single use of magic circuits. They are humans who, despite not being a transcendental race, have the potential to create transcendent phenomena. Major classify them as being psychics. Also human, they are mutants who are born with magic circuits. Such as, without any learning of the occult, someone who can see the death of things. I'm sorry, Archimedes. It appears I can't understand this kind of conversation at all. It's okay if you can't understand, but what I want to tell you is, you shouldn't try to see things that are hard to see. Probably, if you want to, you can see the death of non-living things. But in order to do that, your brain has to open the circuits from the classification of living things to the classification of non-living things in order to understand. It's normally an impossible process. Isn't it a change that happens when a human becomes a vampire? As a result, it overloads your brain and you'll end up being useless. Useless? You mean these eyes won't be able to perceive depth anymore? Of course not. Eshiki, what happens to an engine that blows up from overload? It goes to the junkyard. Once the engine breaks, you can't use it again. Oh, that's it. In other words, headache that I get from seeing death is like a screaming of an engine that is working too fast. You understand? If you can't just see it, it will be a problem. But stop trying to see things you can't perceive. Blood vessels in your brain will burst, and it will be all over. I'm speechless. I've been living like this without realizing the seriousness of it all. Really have to thank the makers who gave you those glasses. Most psychics use their abilities without realizing how dangerous they are and end up disabling themselves. Well, those kinds of people are often incompatible with society. So, maybe that's just for the best. So, psychics as basically mutant humans. And often incompatible with society before my voice almost died. I think this is my sixth you can hear me part that I'm recording in one sitting today. I think that basically means that they go either mad with power or something. Just go mad, I guess. It seems like that's the reason I'm here. I let you go back to living the life you had before. Since you said that, and gave me these glasses. I have so much to thank her for, my chest titans. That person, in so many ways, really did save me. Really sharp sensation, not pain, but something strange, like an itch. Vicky? What is this? It was really only just for an instant, but it was like something was in my chest. Oh crap. Not understanding, I placed my hand inside my shirt. Wetness. Something. Something is sticking to my chest. Like ink. Usually, what the hell? Ow. What is this? Something's... What? Pull out my hand from my shirt. On my open palm. First was blood. Thing. Not a strange sensation. It takes me a horribly long time to understand that it's coming from the old scar on my chest. Vicky, that... Yeah. That's weird. It doesn't hurt and not even an open wound. But there's blood all over my chest. It's so... red. beautiful, unmuddied red that steals my eyesight? Well, it doesn't hurt, so it's gonna be okay. That's not how it works. Seems to have stopped bleeding, so there's no need to. Hagrid stares dumbfounded at my hand. No, more accurately, he stares at the red blood coating my hand. Hagrid? Hagrid doesn't respond. He just starts to breathe heavier. As if she's trying to withstand pain. Hey, Hagrid? What's wrong? Does your wound hurt? I grab her shoulders, and then she jumps back as if she was trying to escape. She assesses me like I'm an enemy. What's going on? Short lips. Her voice even contains enmity. I never thought about it. Was she hungry? Did she want to drink blood? Is that it? She averts her gaze awkwardly. What's wrong? Her acting strange. Still haven't recovered yet. Perhaps since I pushed myself too hard, so I'll go back now. Yeah, I guess we'll call it a night. Yeah, I'll be waiting here tomorrow. Not looking me in the eye, Hagrid leaves quickly.